very like interesting. Including what bodies and like these lowland areas. And when we combine this plant growth and dumping waste everywhere, well, extreme climatic events, like when excessive rainfall or the epidemic. So there are soft interventions also that matter a lot. At least in our is the real picture. And select in Bangladesh. So these are the two cities that we did our research. So here, this is here, and this is Selekin. So these cities, because these two cities are in the foothills of the Northeast, and also by the river. They have a major river going in the Mall, Narayan River. Here. Many components, like hydrological studies, engineering. So if you want to know the carbon potential of the city, you need to know the land level. I was about 20 plus researchers, it's a big project. So you can see a lot of techniques here for, and some models. Okay? So what we found in this research is this. So this is what it wrote. In the existing situation, about 15% of the city area is under carbon. This is not managed properly in those cities. So what happens after 5 years in Select, the flooding area goes back from 3% to almost 90%. So returns on investment is very low after 5 years. Almost no return after 5 years. Okay? So same thing in Nepal. It goes back to almost 8%. Okay? Also came up just like, you know, a few months back. And it's a collaborative work with a lot of people. So what we have in this, we use, so let's go back to, so what we're doing here, we're trying to find out this. Improving visual collection generation in the memory of data and how we improve in solid waste management in one of the cities. Okay? So we have one kind of management right now, and we don't have already managed that case. So you don't have different system that you can compare. So that's why what we did is we had randomly selected like 7 households. So 100 households, 7 million or 7,000. Okay. So what they do with that? 54% actually said they're composting. 30% said they are feeding to animals. 12% is provided. 1% don't marry. How this one? This payment scheme is like this. You get service once a week, you get 30 days. Okay? Not like Kathmandu. Kathmandu is once, twice a week. I pay around 400 expensive. But here it is a little cheaper. So 62% of households are getting this service once a week, paying this one. Twice a week, 50 rupees. So what percent is that? Almost 30% additional fee they are willing to pay if the service is picked on time. Those are required for this service on time and speak with me. So on average, it is about 10. I'm not going through all these questions here, but if you're all economics students, you know this is the building function, where one has to come for the housing, and this is the way of what kind of function you should use. But I'm not going to walk through all these numbers. And when you find this estimate, this model, and do your first error with it, you will get marginal willingness to pay for this one. In our case, our activity is what? Clean of it. Rest are just control. Okay? So, and this heavy pressure model that goes in has a lot of problems in our part of the world because it requires market transactions. So we use this, this living standard survey data, but the problem with the data is what? The swift management in the communities are not assigned random. So there is selection bias. You as an economist, like any student of economics, you always need to think about how your data is generated. Is it random? If it's not random, then you'll face these are the like institutional bias here. After managing your bias, almost. Same here. This is for urban, this is hill urban area. This is Tarai urban area. Nepal is by the way. Topographically, geographically, hills, and very good. Meaning, you are very confident about the way they are estimated. And we also did supplement the national study with our case study from Bharatpur. So this is this data from Bharatpur, 1,050 households, similar information. These are the estimates between neighborhoods. Meaning what? If your house is between neighborhoods, you can pay extra. And how much extra? You have to manipulate this a little bit. You just cannot see. This is not percent right now. Okay? Don't you guys have it? They want to pay extra. That's what it means. Positive. Collection frequency. If it is coming more frequent, you are interested to pay more. And if your house is nearby open rent, you tend to pay less. Okay? So you can have some internal consistency. You can see. So on both coefficients, now if you want to find out the marginal price, these are the like some manipulation is required. So I'm not going to like explain this, but there is a way of finding the actual number. So here follow that. So let's pick one thing. Here. Waste collection service in the neighborhood, if it is already built, your house is 34% tax. The price for that house is that much. Is 45%, if it is your house is nearby open rent, it is 11% less. Okay? And there are other like disaster of those households in houses, and then disaster is like prices that we actually need. But our main area of research for this related to wasteland. Okay? So, yes? So what we found is in our show, so we maintain to segregate more. How much more? About 10% higher. And they tend to compost at home, about 12%. Meaning, if women are in charge of managing solid waste, you generate less. You put less waste outside. And you generate some extra revenue, so you resell those, whatever you are segregating. Meaning you are making some money. Okay? That means what? And landfill site lasts longer if you put less there. If you put less outside, the collector put less truck there, meaning they also save some money. There is economics behind these little things, They are this segregation, composting, all those things. Yeah. Women are doing better than men. Okay? And we also did some, intervention. RCT type study, randomized control trial, looking at what kind of intervention that can help households to manage their solid waste. Okay? So I'm not going to describe the details because we're not done. We're actually done with time. So let me just give you the final, some of the summary results. So before intervention, about 25% of households used to segregate and sell. You saw earlier my slide, right? After intervention, it went up by 10 percentage points, meaning about 40% households in the intervention TLOs started segregating and selling those items. Okay? So that's the outcome of the intervention. But we did several rounds of garbage after intervention. Baseline before intervention, we do the out. And after intervention, we do the out. And another round, it'll be like after a year. And after a year, okay. So earlier, what I said, different types of like of this collection efficiency, 20%, existing is 30%, medium, high, maximum, and here we can recover by, I'm not going to. So now we have the policy, right? We have all these things, advice the government, came out in the environment, so it is, there.